humans live, but for how long? They are part of the resistance, and they will be made an example of.
Cyan.
Seen a spider's web strung with dew. That is the web of fate. All possibilities hang in the balance, but as the sun rises and the wind blows, the dewdrops fall in history.
Her visions reveal the truth. All of them. What say you?
Truth? I used to believe in truth. But it is a corrupted virtue in the hands of those like Shelob and Sauron.
Mine the spiders!
army has been productive.
I don't want them idle, seeking ways to amuse themselves.
Oh, I intend to serve you until I die. But I intended the same with Sauron. I can promise you loyalty, but how could you believe me when I've already betrayed one master? It is a very interesting situation.
The lamps of Eregion illuminate a room with a soft glow, one that leaves only the most tenuous of shadows, a light that seems willing to turn corners and reach further than it ought. When we stored these lamps in the Great Hall, I would light them for an evening every midwinter just to ensure they still functioned. They cheered me so much that I always resolved to do so more often, but then I'd forget or put it off. How I miss their light now.
I fashioned these lamps and gave them to the dwarves of Moria.
Then they've traveled very far indeed. But in whose hands?
Future is written or unwritten. My mind could travel up and down these paths, and they were like memories. But like memory, the mind would shape them to suit its ends. Were these my fears or my hopes?
Are these not the same dangers as the Palantir, the Hydir?
There is a risk in all these things, but wars are not won by the cautious.
Smell it! Go into white! am your chosen! Your chosen!
Yes, boss.
You were!
What's up? Something, no mistake. Something bumped into the night one.
Men and orcs have clashed for centuries. In living memory, the greatest battle between them took place near Long Lake, where men, aided by elves and dwarves, battled the orcs and goblins of Moria. The free folk won the day, and some accounts claim that eagles of the Misty Mountains swooped down onto the battlefield, casting the orcs down from the cliffs and mountains where they stood. Seems a fanciful tale. I saw no eagles overhead when Minas Ithil fell, though we did have Talion and his strange powers. We would have welcomed aid from anywhere, even the skies.
The eagles of the Misty Mountains are more than a myth.
Perhaps, but I doubt they'd fare well against the drakes I've seen.
Thank you.
I've never seen a warg, but books and traveling hunters have told me plenty. The goblins of the north can ride wargs as the men of Rohan ride horses. Their howls can be heard leagues away, and their senses are keen enough to track even a ranger. What makes a warg truly fearsome is that they hunt in packs of a dozen or more. Caragors are more dangerous, but they travel in smaller numbers. A feeble blessing, that.
Wargs. I'm glad they don't range into Mordor.
Even a pack of wargs would find survival here difficult.
Thrak.
Across the sky was a band of every color you can imagine. I have never seen anything like it.
Huh.
Don't tell his words, some beautiful clog. Just watch him back in his life. You need to be coming back for the light.
This artifact was a gift from Gondor's other frontier, the long beaches of Unfalas along Gondor's distant shores. Their lord, Galazgil, sent us this ceremonial bowl with water from the river Morthond, and we kept the bowl long after the water had evaporated. I've often daydreamed of visiting Unfalas. I think I'd like it better than the capital city of Minas Tirith. There is too much of the frontier within me to be happy living in settled lands.
This bowl is far from home.
As are we all, Celebrimbor.
My earliest memories are of being nestled under blankets as my mother showed me the illustrations in a storybook about Loki the Larrikin, whose mischief always ended in disaster, though she was always one step ahead of her stern governess. I found the book tucked away years later after I learned to read, and I was surprised to learn that the storybook was full of little morality plays, not the comic tales my mother told. I wonder why she did that.
doggerel to amuse children, I see.
No. Something more. I read this storybook to my son. Long ago.
The distant north have long been named among Gondor's allies, though I've never seen one in person. This cloak is as light as the morning fog on the shoulders. I tried it on once, and its colors seem to shift and blend as the light changes. How meager the product of our looms is when compared to elven handiwork.
I recognize this cloak. It is of my people.
A people we see precious few signs of in this land.
More kills!
Kuru, as my army fought its way across Mordor, I sensed my instincts for battle sharpening. Here in Mordor, the cunning thrive and the dull perish, or they become slaves for as long as the cunning find them useful.
Gondor's artisans rival the elves in their dedication, if not their skill. None more so than our weavers. Paint on a wall or canvas will fade in time, but thread retains its vibrant color for centuries. The Numenoreans taught our people the art of the loom generations ago, and it is a talent we've nurtured ever since. Our tapestries immortalize our greatest triumphs, but it seems there's always another enemy to darken the horizon.
I wonder where this was intended to hang.
Wherever it was, I doubt it still stands. Only the strongest fortresses last long here.
Traitor, if you like, but those will be your last words. Live and let live, eh? Walk away. We'll chalk this up to an amicable misunderstanding. Say we parley, eh? Put down your weapons and we'll talk this out like friends. No? Why not? Why can't we be friends?
On your knees, you will join me
are.
Accept my hate!
No!
To most Gondorians, this Midnight Urn is a simple pot of clay, but to the denizens of Minas Ithil, it represented shared sacrifice that only those who live on the frontier understand. For centuries, the name of every able-bodied resident of Minas Ithil was placed in the Midnight Urn, and at sunset, a name was drawn. That person would have to patrol the city's walls until sunrise. The task was ceremonial once we had a professional army, but that made it no less important. From our earliest days, it was always a neighbor watching from the walls. I was 10 the first time they drew my name, and I've never been prouder, though I could barely see over the parapet.
Why leave the defense of your walls to chance?
It isn't about chance. It's about unity. Everyone's names are mixed together, and everyone takes a turn on the wall.
Guild Arranger.
Kill him! Skin him! Only then will the Mantbreaker be...
The orcs are neither the only denizens of Mordor, nor the first. Easterlings and Haradrim have settled here from time to time, often at the Dark Lord's invitation. They are scarce today, but one can still find their strange artistic carvings scattered in places from Nirn to the city of the Corsairs.
An artifact of the Haradrim. Interesting.
Few find their way this far north, and for that your nation should be grateful.
Minas Ithil is on Gondor's frontier, so we have few occasions for the grand balls and masquerades that are surely common events in the capital city. Fine dresses like this one are worn for ceremony, funerals and weddings mostly, not for lordly entertainment. I wonder if the noble families of Minas Tirith spared a thought for us, holding all of Mordor at bay while they danced.
Another fine garment thoughtlessly cast away.
Who in Mordor would wear such a thing in days like these?
Hanas, discernment. When I labored with the Bringer of Gifts to forge the Rings of Power, even Galadriel did not discern how the rings would reshape the world. Sauron's fair form masked his true nature, and neither the Lady of Light nor I could discern how the story would end.
I never dared to break the seal on this scroll, though I often wanted to. I found it in a dust-covered box with a label marked Maps of Southron Trade Routes. Berenor is a Haradrim, so perhaps this scroll has a map of his homeland. Breaking the seal is strictly forbidden for those who aren't Lords of Gondor, and as much as I'm curious, I know my father would not approve.
Did you ever travel to the Southern Lands?
There is little there that interests me, and few who go there return.
Always soiled.
He despised the greed of men, the predictability of the dwarfs. But most of all, he hated the elves, who wished to embalm the world. Middle-earth will change, he told me. It will bend to my will. It will not be fixed in place, and it will not be restored to the people.
Wishes to remake the world in his own image.
His image will be wiped away from Middle-earth when all is done.
swords are sharp, their bodies ready. I need to go to war! Yeah!
Fair Mordor slumbers, entangled in night. A viper's nest of sorrow and strife, poisoned by pernicious betrayal and blight. Trapped in the grasp of gelid corpse hands. Yet behold, the Bright Lord comes as a wildfire, burning only what is base, and all else may thrive.
Better things to do than play with stinking grogs. But if that's what you want...
Zuka. I wonder if they make our tents drafty on purpose, try to keep us on edge.
Hit 'em hard, and then hit 'em hard again.
Second time.